Hello everyone, my name is Vishnu and he is Ishan. We are from grade 7A in Diya Academy of Learning, Bangalore, Karnataka. Today we are going to learn how to make a simple game named as Jumpy Balls. Now let's not waste the time and get into the project.
So hey guys, as you know, I'm Ishan and I'm gonna share the screen to Jumpy Balls. So many of you people won't know how to come here. So let's just go to my dashboard. And then from here, you can sign out. I mean, I am signing out. You people do not have to sign out, because if you have an account, you don't need to sign out. And let's first, here, let's make a new, and the URL or the place where you're gonna type code.org, just code.org. So you just have to go to the site, and this page will come. You have to go to the sign in button. And here, if you already have an account, you can log in or sign in with this, or you can continue with Google if you don't have an account. You can use whichever mail you want, as this is my mail. So I'm going to use the mail and log in. So here, this is my dashboard. You just have to go to this create option, and if you don't have this create option, you can go down, there will be start a new project. Okay, in this you can press app lab, or from the create also, let's just show you. If you press this create button, here app lab, game lab, blah blah blah, everything will come. So you can just use that. And now this is the place where the action will be taken place. And this is the place of your code. Many of you people would have been thinking that it's same like Scratch. Yes, it's not Scratch, but it's kind of same. But this thing makes you more comfortable. And because Scratch lags and you have to do so many things. So here, first thing you have to do is rename your project. You have to rename it as Jumpy Balls. By whatever your name is. As my name is Ishan, I'm keeping it by Ishan. And I would like to advise everybody to use a computer or a desktop or anything to do all this, because in a phone or a tab it won't work so properly. Please try to use a laptop
or a desktop.
Yes. So here, this is where you get all the blocks. Each one of these will hold different functions. So first, we do not have to code. We should first design the screen. Like, there will be code design data on top of your screen. Just need to go to the design, and you can use a theme.
Ishan, or can you show the demo how it works for them, so that they'll get some clarity kind of thing?
Demo. So let's just show you the how it will demo. Look after completed. Demo, if we want demo, you know, if we see the demo, they will feel like, oh, this one, oh, I know. So, you know.
No, they'll get some idea how it will be.
So this is the project which we have already done. So this is the coding part. It might look too much, but it's not too much. It's very simple. And after your coding, you just have to press run. Okay. So the yellow button is 10, green button is minus 5, red button is plus 5, and each of them is score. So once you have to press start game, then the buttons will start moving. You press yellow, you'll get 10 points. You press green, minus 5. You press red, you get 5 points. So that's how the game works. So you can run, reset, which will make you stop the game. So after you learn how to do this, you can add a stop button also if you want. So let's get into the process. Vishnu will be telling you how you design it.
Yeah.
So let's go on with Vishnu. Vishnu, please go slowly because many people are new to the project.
Yeah. Okay. In this,
what should we do first?
First thing, the basics. You should know there will be some buttons. Means the yellow, green, and red balls are called as, means they are the buttons. And over there, there is a start game, that is also a button. And the score and the your score and the other means from where the value is shown, means from where the score is shown, they both are called as labels. So first start with our buttons.
So
we need four buttons, actually.
So should we drag and drop or should we just press and
have to drag and drop it?
Okay. So let's drag a button here. So before that, I'd like to explain there's something called theme on top. The theme is, you know, you can take a look at yourself. You can, if you put robot, it'll come like this. If you put coral reef and then put a button on it, it'll be this color, all that. So I'd like to go with Area 51, which is my favorite. Where is Area 51? Yeah. So let's start up with buttons. So you need to place a button. Take out the text and type start game. And the ID, make the ID as start.
Start button.
Yeah,
okay,
so
now you can increase the font size over there. Actually,
if you want, you can actually increase the width. If you increase width, this thing will go up, I mean, will extend, and height will extend this. So, I'd like to go with 100 with what it was before. And height was 40. Yeah. So font, when you scroll down, there'll be font size also. You can make it more if you want. But 15
and
is enough.
If you want to make it more, you can make it. And if you want to make be as it is, you can keep it like that.
You can make it small also. And then we need 3 more buttons, as Vishnu told. But then Vishnu.
Yeah.
How should we, make it round?
Yeah, I will explain it.
Just a second. You know, this, you just need to have press this button and then you can duplicate it twice, by which you can get 3 buttons. Okay. Let's take this button. Okay, it's too messed up. So let's start with one button at a time. Let's delete the other 2 buttons. And now, Vishnu, how do you make it in a circle?
Yeah, I'm going to say it. When you scroll down, over there, after clicking a button, if you scroll down, over there it'll be shown as border width. So you have to increase it. No, actually it's not that. Wait. Border radius actually.
Well, you know, Vishnu, you're wrong. It's actually, you have to make the width and the height.
Okay.
And then
we can do it like that also, actually.
There is border radius.
Border radius. You have to increase it so that it will become a round.
And then you can just take out the text.
Ishan,
text should be nothing.
Means decrease the width a bit.
Yeah.
Width, not radius.
Decrease the width.
So that it comes to the perfect circle, yes.
And you can change the background color to yellow, green.
It's your wish actually. If you want to, if you want yellow, red, green, blue, it's your wish, you can do.
It's your wish. So we've gotten a circle. So you don't need to do all this. You can make the width 50, height 50, and the border radius as 45. So it'll become a perfect circle. All you need to do is press it, duplicate it twice, bring it to middle, and one more to the end. You can align it properly so that it looks good. And you can align the start game also to the center. So now all you have to do is change the colors. So you can put one as blue.
It's your wish.
And one as green. You know, I'm telling my opinion. Don't take everything.
Okay.
Let's see.
If you want, you can copy paste our method or you can do it on your own.
You should have to copy paste it. Because
and
you know that
you're forgetting one thing.
Labels, yes,
and IDs of the buttons.
That's correct. You have to change the IDs. Button
or
IDs.
Or else you'll be damn confused in the coding part.
Will be yellow button.
Or you can keep it only as yellow. It's your wish. Up to you.
You can actually put whatever label you want. It's your wish. And here blue button. Because for not getting confused, you can use what we are doing.
And if you have a good memory power, you can leave it like that.
Yeah. Green button. So now what should we add? Should we add text input?
No, you're wrong. It should be a label.
Label. What does a label do? I mean, label means we can just write text, right? What else can we do?
It can be used like two things. It can be used like for displaying some score values or something, and for giving some titles for something, for some game.
Oh, so there are two labels.
Yeah.
Oh, I didn't know about that, bro. Font size, you can make it as you want. And width, you can make it down to whatever it is.
Or you can resize it in the screen in that place itself.
Yes. Then do we need an other label?
Yeah, for displaying the score.
So why can't we put a colon?
Yeah, we can.
Can we put three labels?
For what?
For a colon and the score.
No. It's enough.
No, can't we put if we want?
Yeah, if we want, we can put. If we don't want,
so let's
don't
try that then.
Okay.
Let's try three labels.
I think so, Ishan, you're forgetting one more thing.
What?
Name means you have to add a label for something like jumpy balls, for giving the text like jumpy balls. So
whoa,
that they get to.
Thanks for reminding me, bro.
My pleasure.
Are you tired?
No.
I am tired.
No, I am not.
Okay, so text.
Again, you are forgetting ID.
We can change the IDs
later.
Yep. So let's. So let's just pause.
Ishan, can you make it the width a bit more? So that more numbers more can be.
That's enough.
I think it's more than enough.
Yeah. So guys, we'll just pause it, and then we'll edit to the next part where all the ideas will be done, and we'll go to the coding part. So let me just change the ideas, and we'll be back.
As you have seen before, we have done with the designing part. Now let's head to the coding part.
Well, let's just tell them what did we do. We just changed the label of total score, which is total score label. We added a label and named it as jumpy balls, and then ID we kept it as jumpy balls label. We have the colon label, and the colon label's ID is colon label. So, and there's a display score label, which will display the score of what you have completed. So let's not waste time and go to the code. I know all of us will be excited, but let's just ask it from the expert. So what should we do in the coding part, bro? I'm not so sure.
Okay, now we have three parts of it: the toolbox and the blocks and the workspace. In this tool block box, we'll have UI controls, data control, variables, canvas, turtle, etc. So in this we'll have
The toolbox?
Yeah, that one.
Okay, and this is the workspace. This is our screen. Yeah. Am I right?
Yes, of course.
Nice.
Absolutely right. So now in everything, when we are starting, we have to start with the on event block.
But what I have learned is it's not necessary. What if we need a variable? We can put the variable also first, am I right?
Yeah.
Okay, this so variable project
one is for and one is for assigning. Now we are going to learn about it.
Okay, so now what should I start with? Variable?
You can start with variable or with an on event. But I recommend you to start with the on event.
An on event where is it?
In UI control.
Whoa.
The first thing. Drag and drop.
So.
Okay. Now the next thing is we have to go to the
the ID? It's showing something called ID.
Yeah.
What should we do with that?
ID means which we have renamed in the designing part. So for starting the game, we the ID start the start game ID. Am I right?
Whoa, okay. What is this? I just pressed
start button.
All of this. So is this the start button?
Yeah, okay. That one. And now you have to go to controls.
Okay.
In the toolbox, and over here you have to take a stop time to loop block called
why do we need that?
So that speed of the balls will not increase.
Okay, but if you did not
add this when you're playing the game, if you by mistake click the start game, the speed will increase.
Whoa.
Of the balls, the moving speed will increase.
Okay, let's keep that aside. Let's get back into our project. What should we do now?
Now in the controls itself, you'll get a time loop.
Is this it?
Yeah.
Should we press inside it here?
Inside the ornament, below stop time loop.
Okay, no, below.
Down of it. Yeah.
Okay.
And now you can see 1000 over there. It means 1 second. It is calculating in microseconds. So 1000.
Micro or milli? Both the same, right?
Yeah, kind of. So 1000 microseconds is equals to 1 second. So we have to leave it as it is. And then after that, we have to go to the UI controls.
Yes.
And we have to take a set position and put it inside the time loop.
Set position. Oh.
Yeah, down. Yes.
Okay.
And you have to add an ID for it. ID is yellow button, actually. Yeah,
yellow button.
Yes.
Okay.
And now, if you go to the mathematics.
Yes.
Over there, you will get a random number.
Random number, yes.
Then put it in the place of zero.
Okay.
Yes.
So hey guys, we have edited and we have completed the project. So
we have edited this thing because it's going to take a long time. That's why.
Don't take a long time to explain it to you and then do it because you know we have already eaten up so much of your time. We didn't want to waste much time, so we have completed this by our own. And then
now we are going to explain it.
Vishnu, can I explain this?
Okay. Now, you can see this variable things means in the purple color.
This no, just a second. Why can't we explain it from the starting?
Yeah, of course. Okay.
Right. So, look, this. Wait, what is
it? As you know, we have added already the start button.
On event, and when you look, the on event and the ID, you should click this arrow mark. And there'll be many buttons and the whatever yellow button, blue button, green, this score label, all this. And when you press it, you need to press start button and there's click option. You don't need to do anything to that. You should make a stop time loop and then make a time loop which you will get from the controls.
Now you get both the stop time loop and the time loop in the controls itself.
Yeah. And now you have to go back to UI controls, search for set position, which will mostly be down here. Set position, you have to drag and drop it. And then here you one yellow, one green and one red button. So here you can see the random number which we have put. We have to go to math. If you go to math, you can find the random numbers. So when you go below random number, here this is the x position where you want it to be, which means if you put a random number 30 between 30 and 250, the balls won't go more than the x position of 30 and the x position of 270. And the same way, this all three is the x position. Here, this is the y position where you can see. Look, this is the y position. Wait. What was that?
Yeah.
So this here is y position, which will be, the balls will be near 65 to 300 y position. It won't go above that. And this is 70 70 70. It doesn't make much of a difference because look what it is width and height. So you know it doesn't make a much of a difference. Width height is the what to say, the simple height, width and all. You mean it's not much? Let Vishnu tell it, because you know I'm not much in width.
Basically it's like a boundary in which the balls would not go outside that. It's basically a boundary.
So you mean it's like a square?
Yeah, like how we have in a football boundary.
Whoa, that's interesting.
The ball should not go outside the boundary. It's like that.
Yeah. So after this, here comes the most interesting part. There's a variable. Look at this. It's a variable. Now,
actually, this variable is used for two things. Means for declaring a variable. And for assigning a variable,
you know, just keep the name of a variable like score, because this ID display score label, that to keep it to put a number there, you have to make a variable and name it. As we have named the variable score equals to 0, that you have to get, you will get from variables. As you go into the variables, you need to scroll. You don't need to scroll, it's on the top. Variable x is equal to this 0 or whatever, blank. You have to put it there and then name the x is equal to 4 or whatever you want. So now you just have to go to UI controls, bring on event, and then bring the variable from variable x is equal to 0. Can you see this? From you need to get the x is equal to 0 below the on event. As you go there, as you keep it there, you have to go to math, and here you have to get plus. So this plus, you have to keep it. Wait, let's
in that
just
box.
Show you a example. I'm just showing.
Ishan, you just remove it and then you show, so that they get some clarity.
Look, so it'll become, so you just need to copy the score or just write the score, which is the variable. Look, the variable's name which you put is equal to 0. The same name, you should bring it here. You should write it or paste it here. Then go to math, get place, put it here. So now again put score, your variable's name, then here plus 10.
How much points it should add?
That is your wish, how much ever. So now set number. Set number you will get from UI controls. Why did we put set number? Because here set number, which means the we need to have a number here. If you press a button,
if you press in that table.
Yes. If you press the yellow button, if you press the yellow button, it should have a score in this display. So here you should put set number. So here you should make it display score label and score, the variable's name here. Look, this place where it's highlighted, that place the variable's name. So now you have to add a sound. So you just need to go to UI controls, play sound, there will be an option, get it there, and then after you get it there, so you can go
at a drop down.
Yeah, press the arrow mark, go to choose, and choose like whatever you want, like achievements, ascent, alerts, just go to ascent or achievements or whatever you want, bell, boat. All this, just go select a thing what you like. Look, so if you press this, you can hear the sound. If you go to another one, another sound. It's like that. So it's just like that. I've chosen a sound from achievement.
From the achievement.
So
it's known as a bubbly game.
So,
the sound is bubbly game.
Yeah. So now you don't have to again go to on event and bring it here. You just
copy paste.
Left click, drag it till here. Now Control plus C. and then or you could get your mark here, it'll be there. Now here control plus V, another one will come, but you don't need it, means we don't need it, but you will need. So you just need to control plus C, control plus V, you'll get another thing. Now
but you have to change the ID and the
ID the change the ID score, the same variable will be here. May take out this, you know, it'll be score plus 10 with so you just need to take it out, go to math minus, so score minus 5, so score minus, then the next blank 5, and the same thing here. You just need to again go to display score label, put a set number which you'll get from UI controls, display score label, then play sound from UI controls, get it here, just take a sum. And now you need to again copy paste it, and on event the same thing, you just need to get a blue button, say blue blue buttons, which it'll be there from the arrow mark. Look, if I press it, there are many things, you just need to select the blue button. And now here the same thing, score plus 5, the same thing of the yellow button, just go to math, get plus here and score and 5. So now set number, set number, display score label as you all know, and the variable's name score. Sound, you can again, yeah, I have put the same sound because I like the sound. It's Yavish, whichever sound you need. So here our coding part is done. Now we have to run the program.
Means you have to check it, is it working or not.
Now if you start game, anything.
Now it's moving.
Blue. Yellow.
You get this one.
So the score will keep on completing. So that's how you complete, and our project is done. So hope you guys enjoyed. Have a great time. Bye.